Okay, guys, I'm back with some more King of Fighters 13. This shit still takes a long time to get matches on, ranked matches, so I'm still trying to get some player matches going. The thing is, the matchmaking is still fucked up. I'm still waiting for the patch. And upon waiting for the patch, I've actually been going into training mode, seeing who I can replace. What's his name? I want to replace Robert permanently with someone else. And I was looking to replace Takuma with someone until the Mr. Karate DLC came out. So anyways, with Robert, by now I've kind of pretty much left him out. I dropped him permanently and I replaced him with, Mature, however you want to say it. So yeah, I kind of like her. The only problem is her Dragon Punch move where she jumps in the air and she does like a double blade thing. It's really unsafe on block. I know I really shouldn't be using it that much, but I just have a tendency to use it sometimes. The thing is, it's really bad on block, because I believe you have like negative frames when they block, and then they can get thrown. It's one of those moves that's really unsafe, you know. But, I mean, I only use it for like one basic combo, because she's one of those jab-jab into special, cancel into a super characters. One of those things. So, yeah, Leona. I really don't like fighting Leona players. Because, I mean, a lot of them tend to wake up with EX and that blade move, and I believe it has, like, invincibility on the startup, because it always fucking hits me. So, yeah, I'm always going to leave Kyo as my main character for the first one, because he's the main one I use to do, like, the most damage and build up the most meter. So, by then, my two weaker characters have a bit more meter to work with. So, that's really the strategy I use with my team. I know some people put their main person, like their best character, as Anchor. So they want to save their best character with a lot of meter for last, I guess. But I'm doing it the other way. I'm using the best character in my team as the first one. And King players, man. I still fucking hate every King player I see. I mean, all of them play the same. They all just repeat throwing that Venom Strike Fireball. And when I dodge that, they do into that spinning kick. That shit. And that move seems like it's really safe on block. It looks like it's really safe on block, because whenever I block it, see, I try to attack him, but he still has time to block. So, I kind of later on figured out, okay, let's try a grab, and it kind of tends to work. I'm not sure if they have a lot of recovery frames when you block that spinning thing with the kick. You know, the one that King does. I don't know if I block that, if they have enough frames to recover to do a tech grab. I don't know about that. But I think the grab is the best thing I can do on block on that annoying move, on that shit. That is really fucking annoying. Because all the King players just tend to play the same, really. They all tend to play the same. So I got Mature now on my team. I also replaced Takuma with Ryo. Because, I mean, his combos are really, really strict with timing, and I was getting fed up with him. So he doesn't have an uppercut, so I was getting tired of it too. I don't really like him too much anymore, so I dropped him for the Mr. Karate DLC. When that comes, I'll use him, but for now I'm gonna be using Ryo, and I think Ryo is a bit better. He's a bit better, I think. Oh, even though he has a really short range fireball, I think I did a bit better with Ryo anyways. Yeah, I really don't like that wake up EX move with King. Like her flash kick thing, where she does a backflip, and if it hits you, like, it pulls you in for like a few consecutive hits. Like, the first initial hit of that, it seems to have a really huge hitbox, because it seems to pull me in from a really big range sometimes. Like, even when I'm jumping. I don't know, I think the hitbox is pretty big on that move. It's a pain in the ass. I really don't like that move. So yeah, I switched to Kumo for Ryo. He doesn't really have jab-jab-jab combos. He's more like a heavy hitter. You know, if you get a chance to do a combo, it'll do some pretty good damage, and it doesn't really take too much timing to do his simple combos, really, I find. No, I still haven't gone into hyperdrive combos. I don't get the timing for that stuff yet, so like I said, I mostly keep my hyperdrive meter just for canceling special moves into supers. That's mainly what I keep them for anyways. So that's about it for that round. And now I'm playing this other dude. Yeah, it really sucks that the developer didn't put the gamer tags or the IDs of the person you're playing when you're watching the replay match. It sucks. I mean, so you've got to point out every time what your team is. I don't see why they couldn't put down the your names, you know. Street Fighter 4 has them. I don't know if Guilty Gear or, what is it, Arcana Hearts. I don't know if they have them too. I believe Marvel vs. Capcom 3 has them. Marvel vs. Capcom 2, I don't know if that has a replay feature. I don't think so. I don't know. Well, my point is, for a game, you know, that's coming out in 2011, it should have had it. It's something they should have had it. I don't see why they didn't put it in the replay feature. Because it would have been nice to see who you're playing with. Honestly, I don't fucking know who this person is anyways. Like, every match I start replaying and recording, I don't even know who it was. I really don't know. All I know is the team they're using, and that's about it. But anyways, one thing I tend to do against Clark players is I don't want to stay grounded. I tend to jump a lot. Like, a lot, really. Like, a shitload of times. I don't want to stay grounded because he might pull out the instant command grab or the one with armor. And that's really just going to grab me and start me, like, putting some pressure on my characters and getting up. So, I tend to use wake-up rolls a bit too much, I find. Instead of, like, sitting and blocking, I tend to use rolls a lot, I find. I should probably change that habit, though. Right there, I don't know why I threw a fireball. I don't know. I should have just went for a juggle with another super, or even the one where he rushes at you and then he grabs you. I don't know why the fuck I did a fireball. Just screwed up everything. Anyways. I don't know how invincible his jab uppercut is, though. But it comes up pretty quick, and it seems to beat out a lot of moves, too. Or if it doesn't beat them, it tends to actually trade hits with them. But I don't know. I think him and Yorei and Ryo have some good uppercuts. What's his name? Ash? Yeah, he has some good uppercuts too. It seems to beat and trade a lot of hits too, so that's a pretty good one. Yeah, Mature's Fireball. I mean, because it has, like, you gotta go down, forward, and then forward, down, and then back. I mean, it's basically a quarter circle forward and then a half circle back. And the animation is like really slow. It's really slow. And the traveling speed of that is slow, too. And I find for something like that, it should have had some kind of super move properties where it could absorb an attack or a fireball. But it just acts like a normal fireball. I mean, for the speed that it goes and for the command inputs you got to input, I think it should have been a little better. I also don't like her normal attacks. Her normal attacks are really shit. Especially her jumping fierce kick. Because her jumping fierce kick tends to go on an angle upward. It's more like an anti-air kind of attack if I jump up. Because it doesn't really aim downward like normal jumping kicks would. And the problem with her jumping weak kick, it also aims a bit high too. But more of on a horizontal line. But the thing is, her jumping attacks with the kicks are pretty bad. And her sweep from a crouch position is really slow. It is really fucking slow. Like, it pisses me off a lot of fucking times, too. Because, I mean, you're trying to do different setups, and you're trying to end up with a sweep, but then it comes out really fucking slow, and then the enemy sweep comes out faster and hits you. So, yeah. Man, I fucking hate Joe players like this. All they fucking do is run away and throw tornadoes, and then do the weak kick, flying kick, and then run away. Fucking little bitches, man. Holy shit. So this fucking Joe has to die. He has to fucking die. See, look at this. He just does the same shit. And the problem with, I believe that move, I think it's pretty safe on block too. I don't know. I don't know all the frame data on this, but it looks like it's one of the moves that's pretty safe. Although, I think it's only safe if he hits with the tip of it. If he hits it when it's like too close, I think I'll still be on advantage. I don't know. Terry. I did try Terry once, even though he's no longer on my team. I tried him once. He just wasn't for me. Yeah, I tried a lot of mix-ups with Kyo. Tried doing short chain combos from crouching weak to crouching weak punch. And going into, was it down forward fierce, and into his jumping kick or the double kick, whatever. But my point is, sometimes I try to change it up to do a couple of pokes and walk in for a grab, or one crouching poke and then go into an overhead. It seems to catch a lot of people because everyone seems to block low after a jump kick. So it's pretty good to change up your mix-up. Yeah. Kyo has some easy combos. I mean, if you're looking for a character that has... Oh yeah, this part. And then I give him my freaking super too. I didn't think he was going to pull out his super right there too. So I took a chance to use mine. I took a chance. I know his level 2 comes out a bit faster too than his normal level 1s, which is pretty good. So anyways, like I was saying, if you're looking for a character that has some easy combos and pretty high damaging, and easy combos for canceling supers, just try Kyo. I mean, his basic stuff works for me, so it can work for you too. He's one of those characters that doesn't really take too much effort. Not really. I think one of the harder characters to use is, what's his name? That dude there that has like long limbs. I forget his name. And he has like the ghosts. I forget his name, but that's a brief description of what he does. I know he's got long limbs, and he shoots like slow traveling ghosts. And I know he has a teleport. I forget his name. I think I used him like once. That was it. I just found him too slow. Yeah. I did try Vice, but I don't like her because she's like a grab character, but I just don't like the properties on her moves. I just don't like the way they are. I don't like them at all. I did like Shermie in Neo Geo Battle Coliseum. The moveset she had in that game was pretty good. So I liked her in that one. So if you haven't noticed yet, I'm using like the same combo with Mature whenever I get a chance. If it's stuttering with crouching jab or crouching jab into standing weak kick for two hits. But yeah, I'm just using like the same combo that works. I mean, you don't really need to use like the most advanced combos, I find. Like even like the simple ones will work. As long as you get like the timing down for them and know when to use them, I think you'll be okay. Like, I don't even use hyperdrive combos, and I'm still doing alright. I don't know, I tried to roll there, but the roll just didn't come out. So, I've been trying to play some people where the connection's like really shit, but the lag is pretty bad. A lot of times, it's not even worth playing at all. It's not. So, like, my King of Fighters 13 matches are not going to be coming on too often, as I said before. Because, I mean, the ranked matchmaking is really ass. It really is. I don't know why I took the normal Iori here. I really don't know. Like, I was trying him in training mode, and I was thinking, oh yeah, I got some badass combos. But, I mean, doing it in a match just wasn't really working out. He does have combos you can do crouching weak kick into crouching jab into his double claw hit. And then link it into a special, then go into a super, but you gotta be really close. You gotta be really close. I think the EX Iori, the Iori with flames, is overall better than this one. But I'm not gonna pay for that, because I don't really want to use that Iori. He has a cool Neo Max, though. I'll say that. His Neo Max is better than EX Kyo. That's what I'll say. Yeah, so I just tried Iori just for this match, just for a little bit, just to get the hang of things, but I just don't like him. He seems like he has weaker moves. He just seems like his moves just aren't as good as the Iori of Flames. They just don't feel like they're good. He does have that command grab, which is pretty good, but I mean, the range is really bad. I mean, as much as you can do is, you can do one standing weak kick, which does a low attack automatically, and then cancel it into the command grab. But I believe if you add a jab after that standing weak kick, I think you go out of range. I don't think the EX will grab. I think it will, but I'm not too sure. But my point is, the command grab doesn't really seem too good. Anyways, that's about the matches I have for King of Fighters 13 for now. I'll try to get you guys some more, and let me know what other characters are good, okay? That's it.